morning, everybody. Thanks, Peter. Excited to be here to kick off day two. Hello, all of you, and welcome to Los Angeles, Boingo's home turf. Boingo was born here almost 20 years ago now. So you may think of Boingo as Wi-Fi and airports. In fact, our stock symbol is even Wi-Fi. But today, we're so much more. We're not just Wi-Fi and airports. We're a total connectivity provider. We partner with venues, and we deploy all types of wireless at those venues with our partners, primarily carriers. We deploy 3G, 4G, 5G, Wi-Fi, and now even CBRS as it starts to launch. But we're not just in world-class airports. We also provide connectivity in venues like stadiums, multifamily communities. And probably the one that's the most dear to our heart at Boingo is we're providing connectivity to the servicemen and women where they live, in the barracks, in the military bases around the country and many parts of the world. But you'll find Boingo in iconic locations like the World Trade Center Oculus in New York, Soldier Field in Chicago, and airports from around the globe, London Heathrow, Brazilian airports, and of course right here in our hometown of LA at LAX. And speaking of LA, I have a wonderful guest today, a great friend of mine, and proud to host a discussion with Kathy Schloessman, who's the president and CEO of the Los Angeles Sports and Entertainment Commission. You might hear us refer to that as LASIC in our conversation today. Kathy leads the strategic efforts to bring major events to LA, and wait till you see what's coming. Under her leadership, LA will host a decade of mega sporting events, much of what we're going to talk about today. But before we bring her to stage, we have a video that demonstrates what Kathy and her team have been up to.
I love Los Angeles. This is our house. Our home sweet home.
The Dodgers do the unbelievable, but then again, they're the Dodgers.
Come pull up a seat. 10 world-class venues. Eleven franchise teams.
Like that, baby!
Touchdown, Rams!
More than any other city in the world.
And it's gonna fall for Ibrahimovic! Oh, come on! Come on!
This is our house. Our blue skies. Our history. Our pride. Our fans, our moments. And it's our future.
In 2028, we're bringing the games back to LA.
The King, he's taken his talent to Los Angeles.
Being able to play for a historic franchise, this is a dream come true for me.
This is our house. It's noisy. It's colorful. It's proud. And everyone is welcome.
Welcome to the show!
Wow, what an incredible video. And with that, I'd like to invite Kathy Schloessman, President and CEO of the Los Angeles Sports and Entertainment Commission, to join me on stage. It's a long walk.
I know. Hello.
Great to see you. All right. So, Kathy, thanks for joining us. We have the mobile world here today.
On behalf of the LA tourism industry, thank you guys for coming back to Los Angeles. Is everybody having a good time in LA?
Always selling. Love it. So we think in this room of the next decade, is 5G. First, before we start, I didn't describe your role. Can you tell me a little bit about what you're doing and how this got formed?
Sure. We, the Los Angeles Sports and Entertainment Commission was founded about 25 years ago by our mayor, Richard Rudin, to help bring major sporting and entertainment events to Los Angeles. Our job is actually not just to bid on and secure these major events, but to make sure that once they come, they're successful, they're sold out, they have the support throughout the entire city, and they want to come back.
So how do you get these events? How do you get them awarded? What's the process to make that happen?
Right, so the process is not unlike what you would go through in bidding on an airport or major venue. There's an RFP, there's a proposal, there's an in-person presentation, interview, and then they select the cities. But it's very fierce competition to get these events because of the economic impact, the social impact, the media visibility that comes with these events. So the things that they're looking for are first and foremost the primary venue, the stadium. And we have the biggest, I think, competitive advantage right now with SoFi Stadium, the newest state-of-the-art stadium in the country. So the primary venue is important. What people also don't realize is it's not just about the big event. So as an example for the Super Bowl, there's 20 or 30 other events going on during the week leading up to it. And so they're looking for proposals that include a couple of alternatives for each of those 20 to 30 venues. You have to, as the bid committee, you have to go out and secure those many years ahead of time at an advantageous / free rate for them. The hotel package is important. They want to have a number of hotel rooms. As an example, the Super Bowl is going to book 60,000 hotel room nights, so you have to lock those hotel rooms up in a convenient location, convenient to the venues.
Wow.
And also, you have to have everything from the economy hotels to the five-star hotels so they can take care of everybody. The events are looking for marketing, promotional, and advertising support, not of the big event, but for everything else they have going on. They're looking for community, business leader support, and also they're looking for financial support, private and public. But I think the biggest thing that they're looking for, Mike, is great guest experience. At the end of the day, these are their signature events. Their guests have to have a great time or they're not coming back.
And so what are some of those experiences that they're looking for?
So when I say great guest experience, it has to be from when they arrive to when they leave. So it's not just about the big event that's taking place in the stadium. It's all the other ancillary events that they're going and attending. So they have to have a good hotel location that they can walk to where they're going to or easily get to where they're going to. Transportation plan is key. It's got to be convenient. The airport's got to be good, and you know something about that.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, that's one of the things that Boingo does. I mean, if you flew into here through LAX, you've seen all the construction, so there's a ton of money being poured into that, as Kathy highlighted, years in advance. But that's where it starts. When they arrive here, you mentioned transportation, how you get around. Mm-hmm. If you've been in LA at all, transportation's pretty hard, but a lot of people...
But getting better.
Getting better,
yeah.
I'm not sure about that.
Yeah.
But a lot of people in this room are working on that, autonomous driving and, you know, the experience in hotels. And, you know, at the end of the day, they all want connectivity. When they want to look at their phone or they want to access their device, they want to have
technology. Technology infrastructure has got to be key. And that's part of the public support you have to have. The city has to have invested in all that technology support because, and you guys know this better than we do, that people only notice when you do a bad job. If everybody's connected and everything goes well, they just take that for granted. But if you do a poor job and you've all been at major events where you haven't been able to send pictures or connect out of it and everybody complains and they remember that, and that's not what you want them to walk away. So we are, Los Angeles, the city, is investing a lot in the infrastructure for transportation and for technology to make sure we can host all these major events in the future.
Well, that's great news for all of us in this room, for sure. So let's talk a little bit about technology for a second. The Olympics is coming here. So what role did technology play in getting the Olympics in the bid?
So technology played a huge role in the LA 28th bids team. So I think everybody saw Mayor Garcetti was here yesterday. So the LA 28, we're hosting the 2028 Summer Olympics in Los Angeles. And Casey Wasserman and Mayor Garcetti, they really sold the IOC on the complete guest experience from door to door. So from the minute that you access technology to buy your ticket to when you land at LAX to when you're going to the hotel and to the events, the whole entire experience is going to be powered by technology. And that was a very big selling point. And while it's nothing novel, everybody says, well, of course, it's important and it has to be there. And so that was a big selling point for them. Another thing that I think is interesting is being done already, but what they're going to do for the Olympics here is there's going to be no cars driving to the venues for any of the Olympic events. It's all going to be public transportation. And how they're going to do that is when you go online and buy your ticket. Your ticket, while you may think you have a ticket and you can go to the game, your ticket is not valid until you go online and choose your mode of transportation that you're going to take to that event. Now, you can change that later, but that will give the event organizers an opportunity to have enough staffing in different places and know where everybody's coming from so they can manage the guest experience so the lines aren't long and everything is more convenient because they know how people are coming. Right now, they're just guessing, and some of the biggest sports disasters have happened. I remember, not to mention the New York Super Bowl, but they didn't know how many people were going to be on. They didn't have enough staff and trains and stuff available because they didn't know. I mean, how do you know? So this way, they're mandating it for the future. And I think that the last quick story I want to tell on how they use technology is when the bid evaluation committee came to Los Angeles to tour all the different venues. They wanted to make sure they had a good process. You obviously want to show off the best of your city. So our friends at AECOM, who did the whole transportation plan and so much in putting together the bid, they sat down at command headquarters where you can see all the timing of the streetlights.
Yeah.
And so for the whole entire route for the bid evaluation, they made sure and timed all the streetlights so that nobody was stopping. There was no traffic making your way around on a weekday in Los Angeles. Wow. And I think that's great. I mean, that's a competitive advantage that any city could take advantage of. Absolutely. If they have the ability to do it. And that's why technology and infrastructure is so important. You can affect the guest experience in a lot of ways.
So a great use of technology. As I live here, and anybody who lives here in L.A., I'd like to get the number of that guy who can fix those streetlights, make it work. And on the ticketing process, I was thinking, I'm pretty sure my mom's not going to be able to get a ticket now if she has to go through all that, or she's going to have to come with me, I guess.
Yeah. Right?
So that's great. So the other thing that's interesting is just what happens today. It wasn't that long ago that if you didn't have a paper ticket, you couldn't get into an event. And so we're Clippers ticket holders, and
now it's the reverse, right?
Yeah, you can't even. There's no paper tickets.
Yeah,
you can only do it digitally. And what are some other use cases that you see? Like we in the industry look at artificial intelligence and voice recognition. You know, some of those benefits come into people that are in the events. Then once they're there, to understand that maybe the bathroom lines are shorter, or they can get their food quicker, things like that. Are you seeing anything else like that, or it's coming?
Yeah, so a couple things. I mean, again, nothing novel, but it is being used. Facial recognition was used at Staples Center for the NBA All-Star Game in 2018, very effectively. I think that, interestingly, our friends at LA Tourism told me the other day that at the Mobile World Congress in Barcelona, they learned about how we're not going to be having lines at events anymore, which is a huge
Absolutely.
Problem, because technology will allow you to see what the lines are, what the ideal time is to come, and you can avoid the line. So between that and how they're going to manage transportation in the future, and you said we're just getting rid of all the problems for most of the problems for major events.
Well, and the reality of it is the events, and even if you look at the team owners and that, they want people in the stadium. And so any way the technology can enable that to happen in a more convenient way is going to be positive.
Well, so I think that's a really important point, that in the sports business they call it butts in seats, that the technology industry, and through 5G, has to figure out how to make the experience in the arena, in the stadium, more compelling than watching it at home. Right. And that is going to be the biggest challenge going forward, because it is so fast. There's so much you can get on your television or at home now.
Right.
What is the reason, what is the reason to come? And I know Steve Ballmer with the Clippers is very big in technology and what he's doing and proposing to make sure that he's going to continue to drive, people butts in seats
exactly.
in to watch the games.
And we're also seeing, if you think of like gambling, and legal, like the sports leagues are engaging, the teams are engaging. But it's really going to require a lot of what Boingo does and a lot of our partners do in making it high bandwidth and low latency, so you can make that micro bet that says, I think the next shot will be a three, they'll make it, they'll miss it, and things like that. So that's another reason. The only place you're going to be able to do that is in the seat at the stadium.
Which is a great advantage. I mean, any advantage like that comes forward is going to help us with these live events and continuing to track, because that is the biggest concern of all these events, is how do we make it more compelling so we're going to continue to drive business to the stadiums and the arenas.
Exactly. So one more question before we go. So why are these events priority for the city of LA?
Right. So I think a couple things to remember on this. Number one, the most obvious one is economic impact. A Super Bowl, as an example, drives $250 to $400 million of economic impact to a city. A second one is the international media visibility that follows these events. Again, using Super Bowl or a World Cup that we'll have in 26 or the Olympics, there is so many credentialed media that come to the city, not just for the event, but they come weeks and months before, and they're looking for stories, and they want to tell stories. So we can use that spotlight to highlight things that we want as a tourism destination, and you can't buy that kind of media. So the media is super important for a tourism destination. And then the last thing is that people forget is the social and the community impact. The job opportunities that come for small and minority-owned businesses, the volunteer opportunities for kids who want to get in the sports business and don't have a way to break in, the participation opportunities, the sense of pride that you get from hosting these events. There's been studies done. They are really important to a community and the growth of the community, and I think that is why it's so important. I think people need to get to look at these events as not just the major event, but everything that happens around it, everything that happens in the community. It's just a great opportunity, and that's why cities compete so fiercely to get those things, and I think we've done a good job. We're calling the decade of opportunity. We have from 2020, we have the Major League Baseball All-Star Game, we have the NCAA Men's West Regionals, we're hosting the Super Bowl in 22, College Football Playoff National Championship in 23, the U.S. Open at LA Country Club
right.
in 23. We'll be one of the host cities for the World Cup in 2026, and then our crown jewel, the Summer Olympics and Paralympic Games in 2028.
Wow. Well, how incredible is that? And Kathy's very humble, but she and her team play a great role in making these things happen.
We'll have a great board of directors who support our efforts. So.
Well, and as Kathy said, when you think about the technology that's going to be required to make this happen, I think LA is going to become, you know, one of the model cities probably around the world of how we do this. So both personally and professionally, that's good, as you know, the airports will gain improvement and we'll be able to bring technology and all the great things that everybody in this room are doing. So again, we think in terms of the next decade is the 5G era, but in LA, it's really the decade of mega events coming. And Kathy, thanks so much for being here, and thanks for all the work you're doing for Los Angeles.
Thank you for all your support. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much. Okay. Thanks, everybody.